Students right across the country in years 3, 5, 7 and 9 will this week have their literacy and numeracy skills put to the test as NAPLAN begins. But with nearly half of students showing signs of test anxiety, what can you do to set your child up for success? Let's bring in Sarah O'Doherty from the Australian Association of Psychologists. Good morning to you, Sarah.
Good morning.
Let's start with the basics. For those who don't know, what is the purpose of NAPLAN? What are the results used for?
There's a few things that the results can be used for. So first of all, testing the child every couple of years gives the opportunity to see how they're tracking alongside national standards, and also to compare them to their age peers. It's also really about being able to see that broader national snapshot of how kids are going across the nation and meeting education standards. I think that there is a less of a focus, though, on why we need to be focusing on that national standard rather than focusing on the individual child. Mm-hmm. And that, I think, has been quite challenging and brought up a lot of test anxiety for these kids.
Because you hear stories of people sending their kids to tutoring so they can go well in NAPLAN and things like that, but it's not necessarily what they need to do, is it?
Absolutely not. It is about getting an understanding of how that child is meeting those expectations and those learning standards right here, right now. And so if that person, that child, is being sent to tutoring, it is about preparation where maybe they don't need to be getting that preparation. So it might be a lot of resources for the parents when it doesn't really need to be happening.
So what are your tips then if you're a parent out there and you've got a child who is a bit worried this week, a bit anxious about doing the test? What are your tips for the students?
First of all, listen to their concerns, validate their emotions. If they are able to articulate those emotions, listen to them. If they're not really able to articulate those emotions, being able to notice any changes in their behaviour that might indicate anxiety. So things like changes to their eating habits or changes to their sleeping habits. If they are feeling agitated or if they're expressing their emotions differently to how they would normally express those emotions, notice those changes and definitely seek support and help for your kids.
What about the students themselves? What can they be doing?
They really need to be taking the pressure off themselves a little bit. If the school or if other people are letting them know that there is a lot of pressure riding on this test, they need to know that it isn't really going to make that much of a difference in the future. It really is just about getting that snapshot of how they're going in the moment. And so if they get a good night's sleep, make sure they have breakfast in the morning, and take it easy, knowing that it's not really going to be a life-changing test. There's no pass or fail. That's a really important thing to remember.
Now, they won't get the results straight away. I think when they come out, they get put in a sort of level of band.
That's correct.
That's how they get their results. So if the results do come back and your child is disappointed with how they've done, how should parents handle that?
First of all, it's to know that these can be opportunities to learn. And so if the child isn't performing in the way that they really would like to be performing, the school, the parents can identify where this child might need additional support. Or it might be just about letting them know that, hey, in the context of school life, it's probably not the most important test they're ever going to be taking, but still validating their emotions. It's absolutely normal to feel disappointed or anxious or sad about the kind of results that they might be getting.
All right, Sarah, thank you so much for your time and expertise this morning.
Thanks so much for having me.
Clint.
Hey there, Today fans. Sarah and...
What's my name again?
Oh, my goodness. Carl.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel, though. Subscribe now for more news, special reports and amazing Aussie stories.
And Carl misbehaving,
Whoa,
of course.
That never happens.
Always happens.
What's she talking about?